Hi friends, this is Ravikant, Ravikant Miriala. Yeah, you know me for my books, that is Accounting Standards and Ind AS Made Easy. Yeah, I wrote book on auditing and assurance, that is Auditing and Assurance Made Easy, that is for CA IPCC, that is a CA inter level I wrote. Final book is yet to come. Yeah, anyhow, this small video I made it for Karo, okay, on Karo. Right, this first video is basically for Karo applicability. Yeah, many of you may be knowing this, but this is going to be one good recap. Yeah, ICAI has issued long ago, they have issued already one guidance note which will be around 200 plus pages only for Karo. Right, so what did I do? I have summarized that points which will be useful. Yeah, so do they ask such kind of questions also? Yes, they can ask, right? And this video is useful for CA Inter and CA Final students. Both of them can use this video. Yeah, see, and if you like it, and please message that, comment, right? And I'll be sharing the next video that is explaining the points. Yeah, you know it, but you just, I'm going to cover all the points of that ICAI guidance. Right, in this 1 or 2 hours of lecture, that will be more than sufficient. Hope it will be useful to you for your exam. And let us get into this Karo. Yeah, see, Karo applicability. I said this video, let's look at applicability. What we'll say first, Karo is applicable to the section. It says very clearly, Karo is applicable to all the companies. Yeah, all companies. All means all. No, not all, but there are some few exceptions. That's why first we say all the companies Karo. First, who should follow Karo? Karo is a reporting, yes, you know, right? It is reporting companies, auditors report order, correct, na? Right? But e reporting order, who should do it? This is reporting by auditor. Yeah, who should check? Auditor should check, right? I am signing the financial statements. Am I supposed to attach this RO report also to this my audit report? That is what either is supposed to look at. Right. So that's whether is it Karo applicable to these companies or not, we have to check. So that's why what they say first. It is applicable to all the companies except few. Yeah. And it is applicable to even foreign company. Foreign company means foreign company which has business establishment in India. Yeah, if it is a foreign auditor, correct, na, foreign auditor, why will he follow Indian rules and regulations? Yeah, we have a foreign business establishment here, then for those people, yes, that business establishment auditor also has to comply with it. That is what we are saying. Right, next, whether auditor of a partnership firm supposed to follow this? Not required. Why? This is a notification. This is part of Companies Act. It is applicable to companies, not for others. So other form of organizations, that is LLP, partnership, or any kind of trust, association, no, we don't need to follow. Auditor need not give Karo report in addition to your main auditor report. Is it okay? Right. But they say except. Okay. Except what? Except these things. First, a banking company. I don't want to write banking under section, which was section not required. Yes. For understanding purpose, sufficient. A banking company, that means banking company auditor will not give a Karo report. That's why if you look at SBI financial statements, you don't find Karo report. Not necessary because they're exempted. Okay. That's it. No. Insurance company. Right. Insurance company, I mean auditors also, they do not give. Next, a section 8 company. What is section 8 company? You know very well. That is basically charitable in nature. Okay, right. So if they are into charity or NGO, such kind of, if they are registered under section 8, then that company auditor also will not give this Karo report. Next, even one person company also they do not. And a small company which is defined under section 2 subsection 85. No, these people or these companies auditors are not going to give Caro report. Yeah, in addition to that, there is one more point which we need to focus. A private limited company, what is it? A private limited company subject to certain conditions, that is what they say. Means, is it applicable to all private companies? No. Right. Tell me, whom do you want to give exemption? We'll give it exemption to small companies or is it for big companies? Obviously, small companies. Small companies. So, what is small? They will define what is small. That's why they say, a private limited company subject to certain conditions. Okay, done. Right. What are those conditions? So, if you satisfy these three conditions, there are totally three conditions. Our full entire discussion will go on that only. Generally, students don't focus on that. One or two times in CA final, they asked a question on the applicability part. In case of private limited company, they gave a small extract of the balance sheet. They said, is Caro applicable to this company? That's it. They closed it. I know theories are correct. Your theory, if you say you know it only when you can implement it. Isn't it? That's why while reading, read it perfectly. Maybe one time or 10 times, read it perfectly. It will be very useful to you. Okay. Right. Let's catch this point. It is applicable to private limited company. If it is a public company, not at all. Okay. Sir, it is a private unlimited company, sir. Private unlimited company. It is applicable because exemption is there to only private limited. See, if you look at the Companies Act overallly, they don't use the word private limited. They use always private company. When you use the word private company, it is applicable to private limited and private unlimited. Right? But here, the wordings of Caro, it says very clearly, it is private limited. But I know there are very, very, very few number of, maybe you can count private unlimited companies. But yes, for understanding the subject purpose, private unlimited company does not have an exemption because it is not in the given list. Okay, fine. So, first, the first to my basic question, subject to certain condition, it is not for all. Yes. Is it applicable to unlimited private company? Yes, it is applicable to unlimited private company because it is only limited person, limited company should be there and the condition should be satisfied. Then they will get the exemption. Next. Is it applicable to branch? Correct. That's fine. Is it applicable to branch? Yeah. Is it applicable to branch? Yes. See, we actually don't check for the branch. We check for the company as a whole. We'll take the company financial statements. Company means HO, branch, everything together is company financials. Got it? Right. One more question can come to mind. Sir, shall I take standalone financial statements or consolidated financial statements? Sir, my company is small when it comes to standalone. My company is big when it comes to consolidated. And then what should I take? You must take only standalone financial statements, not consolidated financial. Okay, checking is based on that. And again, Caro report is given only for standalone, not for consolidated. We don't attach Caro report for consolidated report. Consolidated financial statements auditor report will be just only audit report. For that, we don't give Caro. Caro is applicable for standalone, not for consolidated. Just remember. And your numbers, you are supposed to take it from standalone. Okay, right then. Is it applicable to branches? Yes. If it is applicable to company, it is applicable to branch. Sir, I am a branch auditor. Do I need to give information? Yes, you have to coordinate with the company's principal auditor. Correct, na? Yeah, principal auditor will ask with respect to Caro, what all information he needs. Right, then this branch auditor has to support him by providing the necessary information. Then only principal auditor will do his duty with respect to Caro correctly. Then, right, chalo. Next. Yes. Is it applicable for small branches? See, it's here, first of all, branches not at all relevant. Okay. But yes, sometimes they will ask unnecessary question. That's why I'm also asking now. Yeah. Let us look at those conditions. See, actually, there are three conditions. Okay, three conditions which are applicable to private limited company. And these three conditions, see the point here, you should comply throughout the audit period. It's not just one day, correct? Nah? I mean, any day of the financial year, if you have not complied, means the auditor has to provide thorough report also. Okay, it is not just only on 31st March. Suppose you did not satisfy the condition in the middle of the year on some day, then again it will attract. Okay, done. Next, what are the first conditions? Just let's look at this. Paid up capital plus reserves and surplus. So shall I write less than or greater than? Right. See, I said exemptions are applicable to small companies, smaller version, correct? Na? So what is the smaller? That means less than 100 lakh rupees on the balance sheet date, very clearly said. Right. So for paid up capital, reserves and surplus, you don't need to check throughout the period. On the balance sheet date, if it is exceptions are there like this, if this is specifically, you should follow that. Next, loans outstanding from bank or financial institutions. Okay, loans outstanding from banks or financial institutions. Only from banks or financial institutions. Suppose creditors. No, you gave to companies. The other companies we sold goods. They are customers. They are not bankers for my goods. So nothing doing. That creditor's money will not be included in the loan outstanding. Correct? We'll discuss that again. This also less than or equal to 100 lakh again. Okay, done. But listen, this has to be throughout. Yeah, here how much number they said? 100 lakh. Say example, during the year, there was actually 120 lakh rupees at one point of time. How much? 120 lakhs. Subsequently, they repaid that money. As on the balance sheet, it became 100 lakh. I repeat, in the middle of the year, it was actually 120 lakh on particular one day, on particular day. Let's say some 31st August, they say. Okay, good. 120 lakh. They repaid it, some 40 lakh rupees they repaid. So it became 80 lakh. On 31st March, only 80 lakh. Am I supposed to follow KARU or not? You have to. Why? I said throughout. Yeah, on any day you satisfied, I mean if you did not satisfy, that means your loan was more than 100 lakh, means 1 crore, nothing doing, you are supposed to, your auditor has to provide. What your auditor has to provide? Yes, KARU report he has to provide. Then next, total revenue as per schedule 3, okay, as per total revenue, it is not revenue from operations, got it? It is not revenue from operations, it is total revenue as per schedule 3. What is that? What does it say? Less than or equal to 10 crores. Okay, right. If you satisfy all these, we are going to elaborate each one. Just have some patience. Okay, right. If you satisfy all the three conditions, then yes, you are need not, I mean the auditor need not give audit report. I mean, sorry, not audit report, audit report, I mean KARU report, he doesn't need to give. Is it okay? Yeah. Now, sir, you said paid up capital. What do you mean by paid up capital? Does it mean only equity share capital or does it include preference share capital? Question will come, correct? Na? Right, you have to take both paid up capital, they said. They did not say equity share capital. Right, so you have to take both equity plus preference. I have not written, I am asking you one question. What about application money received pending allotment? Shall I take that or shouldn't? No, you should not take application. Yeah, you can make a note. Application money received pending allotment. No, because they said paid up capital. That is only the under the schedule 3 first paid up capital, share capital. Application money, that is all next. No, it's not going to be part and parcel. Next, plus reserves and surplus, they said. Okay, reserves and surplus. Which reserve you should take? Sir, I have capital reserve. Shall I take or not? I have debenture redemption reserve. Shall I take? I have P&L debit balance. Shall I take this also? Right. First question, without discussion, what is the word they used? Reserves and surplus, they said. Right. What is under reserves and surplus? Every kind of reserve. Did they say only capital reserves?
Did they say only free reserves? Did they use that word? No. So that means reserves includes every reserve. It may be DRR, it may be CRR, it may be revaluation reserve, it may be P&L debit balance or credit balance, general reserve. Every reserve is supposed to be considered for my calculation of 100 lakh. Got it? Right. Sir, shall I deduct miscellaneous expenditure or not? First question. Did they say? No. Keep quiet. That's it. They said reserves. Take reserves. That's it. Okay. Yeah, this is all given in ICAI guidance, my dear. It's not like I'm just telling you. Okay. Right. Reserves means all reserves. Revenue reserve, capital reserve, revaluation, CRR, DRR, debit balance, every balance. Take the balance sheet. Reserves and surplus heading is there. What is the number? A number, just to take it. Sufficient. Okay. Right. What about miscellaneous expenditure? No, you shouldn't cut. This is with respect to first point. Hope you understood something. Then, now let's get into loans outstanding from bank or other financial institutions. Okay, I said loan, it must be loan. But did they say the short term loan or long term loan? They did not say. Did they say secured or unsecured? They did not say. So it does not matter. Loan means every kind of loan. It should be from a bank or financial institution. That's all is the target. Okay, that means long term, short term, correct na? Now, whatever the term, and secured, unsecured, everything is going to be part and parcel. Fine. Then what else, sir? What else means? Yes. Bank OD, sir. Yes, it will come, sir. Cash credit. What is cash credit? Cash credit is a short term loan, basically. Correct. Now, cash credit will have repayment schedule. Generally, bank OD also can have schedule. Some, but generally bank OD is repayable on demand. Generally. Okay. But there are bank ODs where they will give, I mean, like 1 year a schedule also, they will say. Whatever it is, whether it is repayable on demand, whether there is a scheduled payment, it doesn't matter. Bank OD is an OD, overdraft. It's a kind of loan you're liable to a banker. That is also part and parcel here. Got it? Right. So those things are going to come here. All kinds of loan, long term, short term, working capital, cash credit, bills purchased or discounted. Yes, that is also we are liable to them. We gave bills receivable, that bills receivable we gave to them and we got money. Whatever the BR you gave it to them is just a security to the banker. That's it. Okay. Right. In Ind AS, I do obviously explain this. Risks and rewards of the loan and risks and rewards of the bills receivable is still with the company. Why? Suppose I gave some bills receivable, I got it discounted, I collected money. Yeah. Suppose my debtor, he dishonored the bill. Banker will catch me. That means the risks and rewards of the BR, financial asset, is with me. Correct? Now, you are not supposed to de-recognize this financial asset. You have to create a financial liability. This is discussed under Ind AS 109. It is not a contingent liability. It is a pure liability. Okay, that we'll see. That's why they have taken very clearly E point. Bills purchased or discounted. Yes, it is a liability. You have to consider that. Sir, public deposits. Public deposit is from public, not from bank. So it won't come. Debentures issued. Debentures issued, if it is debentures are issued to a banker, yes, it attracts. If debentures is issued to the public or other companies, then it won't. Yeah, creditors are outstanding balances are outstanding payable. Correct? No, no provision for gratuity. No provision for gratuity is a liability to the employee, not to a banker, a financial institution. So it won't be considered. Hope you understood. Now let us get into the next last word. Later we'll look into the some questions. Yeah, what is the point here? Total revenue as per Schedule 3. Okay. Yeah, total revenue as per Schedule 3 is less than or equal to 10 crore. Yeah, now many questions will come. Let us see that. Yeah, what does it mean? Total revenue means total revenue. What is total revenue, sir? Yeah, see the P&L as per Schedule 3. First, what will be there? Revenue from operations. Shall I take it? Yes, that is part of total revenue. Sir, there is other income. Shall I take other income also? You must take. That is also part and parcel. You getting my point? Yes, because total revenue means 1/2, third row, that name is total revenue. You have to take it. Right. So let me write. That is revenue from sale of goods and services. Yes, whatever kinds of sales services. Do we need to take other income into this? Yes, we have to take other income. Then it should be included, because total revenue means including other income. Then, sir, they have given a trade discount. Yeah, if you had given trade discount, you should have already deducted from the sales, na? Yes, it is already deducted, so nothing to bother now. If it has not deducted, deduct it now at least. Okay, for calculation purpose. Sir, what about cash discount? Yeah, from accounting standards angle, correct, na? What will happen? Cash discount. Cash discount will deduct as an operating expense, not of directly deducting from the revenue. Are you getting my point? Yes. So cash discount, don't deduct it, because it is an expenditure separately. Will show as per standards, as per accounting standards. Next, what about sales commission? Sales commission is expenditure. We don't deduct it from the sales. So that's different one. Next, sir, what about sales returns? You have to deduct sales returns from the sales. Sir, one question. I sold goods in the last year, sir. Okay, but it got returned in the next year, sir, April. So such kind of returns are supposed to be deducted for computation of total revenue, or since it is last year, so I don't want to deduct it. Nothing doing. Even though it is related, it is a sales return related to sales of last year, it is happened in the current year, deduct it. Very clearly notified by ICAI. That's why I wrote very clearly here, deduct it, even if it is related to PY. Okay, I hope got. Next, sir, you said total revenue. Is that only from continuing operations, or is it from discontinuing also? You got my point. When they give P&L or balance sheet, by keeping all such kind of points there, then you will get to know to what extent you studied. Got it? That's why I'm saying read carefully. Point by point you read. Yeah, one time you read like that by making so many questions in your mind, I don't think you will forget so easily. Got it? Done. So, my dear, yes. Now sales returns, I said. Right. Next, sales tax and excise duty. Yeah. First, I was telling what? Continuing, discontinuing operation. Very clearly said by the section, both you should take it. Maybe for the presentation purpose, discontinuing operations may be taken down or separately in the notes to accounts. But for CARO computation, for CARO eligibility computation, one has to consider discontinuing operations income revenue also must be considered. Okay, next. What about sales tax and excise duty? GST, you mean to say. Both you delete and you write GST. I don't have a problem. Correct? What are you supposed to do? GST is not my revenue. We shouldn't take it. Don't add it. Why? Revenue, this is a liability. We are an agent to the government with respect to GST. We are collecting it from the customer, and we are liable to pay them. The minute I receive money of GST, I am obligated to give it to government. So that is not my revenue, first of all. Okay, that's why we don't consider when they have accounted separately. Anyhow, everyone accounts separately only, correct? You know, obviously, when you sell goods, what do you say? Debtor account debit to sales to GST payable, correct? We collected, we have to give it to government. Done. Is it including discontinuing? Yes, specifically said in the section itself. You have to consider both. Got it? Right. Based on this discussion, let us look at some 3-4 questions. That's it. Then we will go to what is that? Next part. Chalo, my dear. Now questions.
A private limited company is incorporated on 1st July 2016. Okay. During the year ended 31st March 2017, it had issued shares. Shares means paid up capital 40 lakh. Borrowed 7.5 lakhs of each from two financial institutions. So 7.5 into 2, 15. Okay. First of all, paid up capital, this is 40. This is less than 100 lakh. No, first condition satisfied. 15 lakh hardly. That is less than 100. Yes, it is from bank, financial institution. Yes, it is also not applicable. Its turnover, that is net of excise. It's okay, 475 lakhs. But that is 10 crores, na? Yes. So it satisfies, it's a private limited company. It satisfies all the conditions. So you don't need to follow, you don't need to give CARO report. Right. So how to document it? First, you have to mention what are the three conditions given. Yeah, you should say private limited company is exempted subject to the following three conditions. Yeah, document that for the three conditions. Then you say in the given circumstance, the company has satisfied all the three conditions. Hence, CARO is not applicable. If you write like that, perfectly you will be awarded with full marks. Okay, done. Next question. A T private limited paid up capital reserves are less than 100. Okay, satisfied first point. It has no outstanding loan exceeding 100 lakh from bank or financial institution. Super. Second condition also satisfied. Its sales are 11 crore. Okay, 10 crores is my target, 11 here. But this is before deducting trade discount of 10 lakh. Okay, now let us discuss. Discount, deduct it. 11 crore minus 0.1, 10 lakh. Sales tax, sales returns also they have not deducted. Okay, cut it, 0.95. The service rendered by the company amounted to 10 lakh. Then what should I do? Plus 10 lakh. Yeah, because it's sale of goods and services. So 10 lakh. The company, what is that? Contents, that report under CARO is not applicable. Nothing doing. Because if you total, 11 crores minus 10 lakh minus 95 plus 10 lakh, it will cross 10 crore. Since it is not satisfying the turnover, total revenue concept, it has to, correct, it's coming to 10.05 crore. You have not satisfied, CARO is applicable for that auditor. The auditor has to give CARO report also. Okay, CARO is applicable. Look at this next one. Yeah, see, just go through this. You can pause the video and go through. Yeah, they took overdraft from two banks. Fine. A limit of 50 lakh each. Against the security of fixed deposit, that doesn't matter. Okay, fine. And unsecured loan or unsecured overdraft from financial institution, 9 lakh. Is sufficient, 50 plus 50, correct, two banks, 100 lakh plus 9 lakh. You already crossed, right? Quickly speaking, you don't need to read the full, right? That's it. You can go through, obviously. Yes, total loans is equal to 109. CARO is applicable. Next question is something interesting. Let us see. X Private Limited is a subsidiary of a listed entity incorporated outside India. Okay. The management of the company believes that since X is a private limited company and it satisfies all the following conditions, CARO is not applicable. That is what. Think of what do you say. I'll ask you some question. Let's see. X is a subsidiary of what? Another listed company. Listed means the other company is what? Public company. Right. So, a subsidiary of public company must be a public company. Yeah, if it is a public company, exemption rule is not applicable. What do you say? Yeah, let me answer this. See, as per the Companies Act, yes, first point what I said, a subsidiary of a public company is public. I agree to it. But subsidiary of a public company means other public company also must be public company under Companies Act, not a foreign act. Read the question carefully. It is a subsidiary of a listed entity incorporated outside India.
Yeah, that means now we don't look at the holding. Who is holding? We don't need to look at, because other part that is holding is not Indian. If holding is Indian public listed company, then e private limited company also will be treated as a public. But in the given circumstance, it is a subsidiary of outside Indian company. Correct? Now, outside India company. Now we don't look at holding. Now we look, X is a private limited company. Only from the point view of X we are supposed to answer. Only from the point view of X we are supposed to answer. Now you have to see X independently. X is a private limited. First, small, I mean, being a private limited company, you should check now three conditions. If you satisfy, then CARO is not applicable. And the next few lines, what are they saying? All the conditions are satisfied. Since all the conditions are satisfied, perfect. You don't need to bother. I mean, CARO is not applicable to them. Correct? That is what. Sometimes we get unnecessary. They also will throw some biscuits and we also think too much. Right? This will help. But once you exercise such kind of, once you face such kind of questions, you know, then obviously it helps us. Okay? Right. It is not a subsidiary of Indian public company. So, it should be treated as private limited company as per the Act. Since they mentioned it is everything is satisfied and management obviously correct and CARO is not applicable to them. Okay, right. Watch my next video with respect, like detailed explanation on each point. Why this has come, what is the problem, what is the point behind this and how to read this and how this will be useful to a member. Yeah, right now just applicability we discussed. Right, and again, we recently launched one small website that is ravikantmiriala.com. You can see down here for you can order books. Yeah, you can get a discounted prices. Right, and yeah, videos will be sharing and video lectures also. You can in the future will be selling through this website. It may be useful to you. Thank you. And if you like the video, please comment. As well as please share it to your friends. Let that be useful to required students. Thank you.